So a lot of times in science, we want to explain things in a way that other people actually believe us. And to do that, we've come up with a framework that we call claim, evidence, reasoning. You need to have all three of those parts to make things work. I'm going to illustrate this to you with a murder mystery called Who Killed Franco's Brother and Why? So make sure that you've got all the pieces of the claim, evidence, reasoning. I've given you this template, and we're going to work with this at the beginning here, and I'm going to walk you through it. So the claim is easy. I was given a question, and now I need to answer it. Who killed the brother? Well, I think that somebody did it because of some reason. That's what I think. I'm going to jump next down to the evidence. It's the foundation of science in a lot of ways, which is why I put it down here at the bottom. And these are the actual observations or measurements that really support our claim. It's what I see when I get to the crime scene. And each one of these boxes of evidence here needs to be linked to the claim with reasoning. These are the general principles about the way the world works that allow us to really link the evidence to the claim. It's what I already know about the way the world works. Some scientific principles, laws of physics, those sorts of things are going to go here in the reasoning. So let's see how this works with Franco. So I think Franco killed his brother. Is that complete? Well, no, it's not complete because I asked the question, who killed Franco's brother and why? So this is a nice start, but it's not there yet. So, he wanted his money. Now we have a complete response to the original question, so we have a complete claim. Is it accurate? Who knows? It turns out that accuracy is a really hard thing to assess with lots of scientific claims. And so when it comes down to grading, which is one of the reasons why I'm giving you this video, is you're going to be being graded on these claim evidence reasonings. A lot of times I won't give you any points for the claim because you can say anything you want. You can say Franco killed his brother, Mary killed his brother, but if you don't have the evidence and reasoning to back it up, then there's no point in going there. So let's start with some evidence. We walked into the crime scene, we saw Franco has red hair. Is that accurate? Looks like it from the picture. But it's not really complete enough to convict Franco for killing his brother because he wanted his money. So we need more evidence. Ah, red hair was found under the brother's fingernails. It's not looking good for Franco. Still accurate, but not yet complete. Why not? What's missing? We said that Franco killed his brother, and we might have enough evidence to say that that's what happened there. But we also claimed that he wanted his money, and we have no evidence to back up that claim. So let's add that in. Franco's bank account had no money, but his brother was rich. Accurate and complete now. We've got evidence to support all parts of our claim. So let's start trying to link those things back up. The reasoning behind Franco having red hair, well, that's nice, it's true, but how does that tell us that Franco is the one that did the murder? Well, we have to have this reasoning, things we know about the way the world works. We know that red hair is pretty rare. In fact, nobody else in the entire town has red hair. So if we find red hair, it's very likely to be Franco's. We got this information from what we know about the world. It has nothing to do with what happened at the crime scene. It's something we already knew. Likewise, this sort of general principle. During a struggle, victims often grab onto their attackers to defend themselves. So when you find hair under fingernails, it usually comes from the attacker. So we're doing pretty well here. We've got those, let's pretend those are both accurate, and almost complete. We have this one piece of evidence here that's not linked to our claim yet. We haven't justified why, so let's do that. Okay, when you kill somebody, the law says you get all their money. Franco would be rich if he killed his brother. So now we've linked everything up there. All of our evidence is linked. Uh-oh, wait. Red X. Accuracy. Oh, this isn't true. It's not true that when you kill somebody, you get their money. So while you have done a good job trying to link the evidence to the claim, it's not based upon how the world actually works. And it's pretty obvious when you have something like this with the murder mystery, but when we're talking about scientific principles, a lot of times people have misconceptions about the way the world works, and they're going to put those in to explain their evidence and link it to the reasoning, but it's not right. And we're going to work on identifying those places that aren't right and fixing them through the course of the class. So let's fix this. Okay, people often list siblings in their will, so it's likely that Franco would receive money when his brother died. Now, that's accurate and complete, and we now have a complete claim, evidence, and reasoning for why Franco is guilty. So I'm going to write this out in a paragraph form, because oftentimes it's nice to write things in a explanation comes in a paragraph. And in fact, I'm going to color code it here. All I did was I copied and pasted those things from the boxes in, and then turned the claims red, the evidence green, and the reasoning in blue. And there's also a couple other things here left in black. That's because when we're writing stuff out, oftentimes we need to put transitions in, and to communicate effectively, we need to add some text, and that's going to be an important thing too. So we'll leave those in black. So you've written an explanation like this, and now you want to know, did you do a good job? I'm going to grade it, or actually you're going to be grading a lot of these in teams, and you'll see how that works later. But we need to have a scoring criteria for this. So let me show you how that works. Let's go back to our template here. With the claim, I already told you that we often don't give points for the claim itself. It's easy to make claims, but there will be some situations where there will be up to 1 point that will be awarded if you have an accurate and complete claim. With reasoning, the class is really about reasoning, and we're going to give a lot of points for it. In fact, we're going to give up to 3 points for accuracy, and then separately, we're going to give up to 3 points for the completeness of all of your reasoning. Evidence is also crucial, but I don't want it worth as much as reasoning. So I've sort of merged accuracy and completeness. If you've got both of those things wrong, but you gave it a good try, you'll get 1 point. If you have both of them checked off there, it's accurate and complete, you'll get 3 points. And if you have something that's accurate but not complete, or it's complete but not accurate, you'll get 2 points, something in between. So you've got some gradations. Now, if we're coming up with a scoring criteria and we have different gradations, this screams rubric. So we've created a written rubric that really defines that for us, so a little bit more clearly. So our claim is worth that 1 point, so you get up to 3 points for evidence, and what makes a 2 versus a 3 different. And then these two criteria for reasoning, completeness and accuracy. And each one of these boxes spells out what makes a 3 different from a 2. So for example, the evidence is tied to the claim by scientific principles and established in the class. And there's no extra ideas that are incorrect. Whereas a 2 has all that same stuff at the beginning, but there's some extra things that aren't quite correct. And if you start adding in extra pieces of information that don't make sense, that's not accurate reasoning. And so you won't get full credit for it. So we're going to be using this rubric for almost everything we do throughout the entire semester. And you're going to get some practice on that in your homework, so go ahead and get started.